talk about costs of quality. So if we've got a well-run company, they probably practice total quality management, TQM. They're trying to make better and better products, and they're emphasizing quality control all along the value chain. There are four costs of quality, and they break down into two categories: the conformance costs, prevention and appraisal, where we're trying to get our stuff to conform to our standards, and then the non-conformance costs, the internal failure costs and the external failure costs, where we produce a product that doesn't conform to our standards. And the internal failure costs, we catch them before they go out the door. The external failure costs, which may be the most costly of all, are the products that get out the door and disappoint our customers. One way to look at it might be to say, hey, we're not going to spend $1 million to save $500,000. Another way might be to look at the cost of quality curve, which basically gets to the same concept. So along this vertical axis are the quality costs, and along the horizontal axis is our quality of our product. So if we spend very little money on appraisal and prevention, if we're down here at this part of the graph, we're going to have huge internal and external failure costs. On the other hand, if we spend a fortune on appraisal and prevention, we're going to have very few internal and external failure costs. We want to optimize the combination of conformance costs and non-conformance costs. This curve here represents our total quality cost, and this spot here is the optimal cost of quality. We've got very good quality, but not necessarily 100% perfect. All right, let's do this problem together about Clausen Corp. They manufacture radiation shielding glass panels. And the first thing the problem asks us to do is classify each of the eight costs above as a prevention cost, an appraisal cost, an internal failure cost, or an external failure cost. Before we do that, let's review. Prevention costs are things that we do in advance to make sure that our products are good. Employee training, improved raw materials, and preventive maintenance on our machinery. Appraisal costs, the other conformance costs besides prevention costs, are dollars that we spend to inspect our work throughout the process and the inspection we do when we're finally completed with the product. So prevention costs and appraisal costs are called conformance costs because they're money we spent to try to get our stuff to conform to what we want it to be. Internal failure costs and external failure costs are called non-conformance costs because the stuff didn't turn out as good as we liked. So maybe we had to shut the machinery down to go back and maintain it. Maybe we had some rejected product units so that we had to rework, or we had to scrap. And then we have some external failure costs. These are probably the most costly and the hardest to predict. We're going to have lost profits from customers we didn't get. We're going to have warranty costs. We've got to pay to fix stuff that left our shop and got sold to customers. We may have to travel out to the customer site to fix it. We may have sales returns and just have to give them their money back. So Clausen is thinking about spending this much money to save this much money. But first, the problem wants us to classify these as prevention costs, appraisal costs, internal failure costs, or external failure costs. Strength testing one item from each batch of panels is going to cost us $62,000. And that, of course, is an appraisal cost, because what that's going to do is allow us to detect poor quality goods before they go out. And that reminds me of a story I like to tell. So in this instance, we're talking about breaking one panel to strength test it. So we're probably somewhere in here. We could, of course, if there were 100 panels in each batch, break 99 of them, strength test 99 of them, to make sure that the one is okay. But that is spending too much money on appraisal and prevention, and it's driving our total quality costs up. Training employees, training our suppliers, identifying some preferred suppliers who are going to give us on-time delivery of perfect quality materials, those are all prevention costs. So those are the four costs that we're incurring. What about the four costs that we're going to avoid? We're going to avoid lost profits. So that would be an external failure cost that we're avoiding. We're avoiding rework and spoilage. That's an internal failure cost that we're avoiding. avoid inspection of raw materials. Well, that's going to be appraisal cost that we're going to save. And how do we save that? Well, since we've got suppliers who are giving us perfect stuff, we don't have to inspect it when they deliver it. And finally, avoiding warranty costs, that's another external failure cost that we're avoiding. All right, does Clausen start this new total quality management program? Do they spend $170,000 to save $225,000? Yeah, of course they do. And if we wanted to get a little bit fancier, we'd prepare a cost-benefit analysis where the costs, the bad news, are negative numbers and the good news are positive numbers. And we discover that spending $170,000 to save $225,000 is a good thing. Hope that helps.